Pongo. Gimme Pongo. Good girl. Good girl. Bongo. How are you? How are you? Can you jump? Oh, good girl. You're very good girl. Can you spin around? Spin around. Spin around. Good girl. Can you lay down? Yes. Yes, good girl. Now you have a little cookie. And now we continue our walking, our walk. And hi, this is Bruno. And today I'm going to be talking about what does it mean to be enlightened or awakened. Okay. So, first, we're gonna take a little, very short walk. Maybe we're gonna go down the hill later. And before telling you what really means to be enlightened or awakened, past participle. I need to tell you that you need to get rid of all your expectations. So we think of an enlightened person as the Buddha, who is always in peace, always happy, always content, and very, very kind. There is no evil, nothing bad exists about this very perfect person we see as enlightened. And the truth is that your neighbor could easily be enlightened and you just don't know about it, because it doesn't have to do about how other people perceive you. People don't get enlightened so that they can become gurus or celebrities or make a religion. Enlightenment just happens to you. And yes, it can change the way you talk or the way people see you, but it doesn't have to. It will change the way you think, though. And that's the key, that's the main thing you should understand, that you do not have to quit all your material possessions and go live in the forests or deep in the cave meditating if you are an enlightened person. Once you go through this experience, which can happen in many, many ways, some people just wake up and they are enlightened, I guess. In my case, it was thanks to ayahuasca. It's the medicine from here, from South America. And the way I knew it happened is because I surrendered. So this, it helped me surrender. It helped. It taught me that there was no way to go through it. The only around it. The only way was to go through it. There is no way to fight it. And I also knew I had this very strong experience, or this was it, because I had no more, everything had been answered. I had no more questions about the meaning of life or about my existence, about the universe. Everything was there, was answered, was solved for me. Everything was very, very clear. And even now, it's been more than 6 weeks, and it's still, everything's very clear. I don't know if it's been 6 weeks, but it's been more than 1 month. So I would say enlightenment or being awoken means to see things really clear as they really are, without any biases or prejudices, which had been carved into intrinsically thought in those prejudices or biases, they have been carved into your path, the way you think, the way you process thoughts. There's some neurons in our brains, and those neurons, they make some connections, and they are used to go from one connection to another. For example, if I want to remember the name of the street where I grew up, I would first remember the name of the country where I grew up, and then that's a connection. Then the city where I grew up, that's another connection. And after billions of connections, or a couple hundred connections, I will remember the name of the city. So what happened to me is that even though I cannot remember these specific things, the brain was able to make new connections that had never thought about making before. And I was shown something and went through something that made all these new connections possible. and these new connections between your neurons in your brain helped me understand very deep thoughts about, let's say, existence. And what does it mean to be awakened one more time? It means to surrender, not fighting it, and you will know it happened when all your answers are, your questions are answered. Your questions are answered. And when you don't feel the need to fight against something or fight against your thought, or there's just one way, surrendering and accepting, and there's no way to fight any of this. I'm sorry about the ramble, and sorry if it wasn't clear, and I hope you enjoyed the video, and bye.